One, two, get ready to roll. If you're moving with the beat, then you're moving with the flow. Say three, four, get ready for more. We ain't come to mess around. We just come to hit the floor. Yeah, one, two, get ready to roll.
Hey guys, welcome back to the start of another season with Ramblin' Reflections. Today was a travel day, and we're in Brunswick, Georgia at Blythe Island Regional Park Campground. It's a campground managed by Glenn County. We've never stayed at a county campground before, but that's all about to change. This place is beautiful. It has a tropical feel to it. Lots of palmetto trees and tropical plants all around. It almost feels like we're camping in the jungle. All campsites have water, electric, sewer, cable, a fire ring, picnic table, and a concrete pad. They say free Wi-Fi internet service is available throughout the park. It may be, but we couldn't get enough to upload videos, so temper your expectations there. There's a coin and app-operated laundry machines located at the main office. Oh, and the security gates remain open during the day, but they automatically lock for the evening around 8 o'clock. So make your plans accordingly.
So here we are. We're just pulling in. That's how much space we have at the back. That's how much space we have at the other end in the front. And we have this nice concrete pad and a picnic table. There's nobody in the site next to us yet.
It's the longest campsite we've ever had. There's our fire pit. And we're still going. Check this out. Guys, seriously, can you see Rose down there? She's at the other end of our campsite. Look at how I'm at one end and she's at the other end. That's how long this thing is. It is seriously the longest campsite we have ever experienced.
Several reviews I read mentioned the rabbits down by the office. So, of course, if you know me, I had to go visit the resident bunnies. It was really cool. Supposedly there are several hundred of them. I just got to hang out with a few.
Way to Texas for our youngest son's wedding, but we decided to make the journey across a little more enjoyable, so we're taking a few day stops along the way so we can explore the surrounding areas. Today we're headed to Jekyll Island.
Jekyll is only 7 miles long and about a mile and a half wide. It's part of the Golden Isles of Georgia. If you're not familiar with the Golden Isles of Georgia, that's a collection of barrier islands and port cities that are protected along the 100-mile stretch of Georgia's coast.
Okay, guys, we're at Jekyll Island. We were here last year, about June, I guess it was, and we tried to make it to this beach, Driftwood Beach, but we got to the point, it was a pretty good hike, and we got in a storm, a massive storm. Not only did we get rained on, we got sandblasted from all the sand blowing all over us. So we're going to try it again this year. We're going to see what we can do. The wind is whipping again. I hope we don't get sandblasted, but we'll take you to the beach and we'll let you see why. It's called Driftwood Beach.
Very swampy. But we're getting to the beach.
We made a left turn off the main trail here, and now we're kind of walking out in, what'd you call this?
Some unknown trail.
The flats. Yeah, it's the flats, I guess. Can you hear the water over there? The waves? It is unbelievable. It's just over that way.
Well, we made it to Driftwood Beach. And again, we're disappointed. 1 year later. Well, it is.
On the beach part.
Yeah, the sea is so rough today. You can't get on the beach itself. But you can see why it's called Driftwood Beach. But it looks like we're going to have to wait till March when we make our way back again to try it again, see if we can come out here and see what else you have. So anyway, take you along and let you see a few sights.
On the way back out, we came across this white bird, an ibis. He was pretty cool. If you watch closely, you can see him fluttering his feet in the water. It was such an odd behavior, we had to look it up when we got back to cell signal. Turns out, this is their fishing technique. They stir up the sediment with their feet to flush out insects and crustaceans.
Did you know the earliest name for Jekyll Island was the Island of Whales? But that was a Spanish name for the island. Have you ever wondered who the island was originally inhabited by? For Native American groups that were said to have lived on the island for thousands of years before European contact, 1733, James Oglethorpe discovered the island and named it Jekyll Island in honor of his friend and financier from England, Sir Joseph Jekyll. On April 5, 1768, Clement Barton, a British settler, was granted Jekyll Island by the British Crown to encourage settlement and development of the Georgia colony. When he died, it was passed down to his son, John Barton. However, during the American Revolution, John was charged with treason as he was considered a royalist, and the property was confiscated by the government in 1776. It was later sold at auction to Richard Leake, who turned out to be Martin's brother-in-law. So I guess you could say the island stayed in the family for 26 years. Well, that all changed in 1794. Leake sold the island. This time the island would remain in the family's possession for almost 100 years before being sold. You won't believe who they sold the island to at that time. More on that in a little bit. Enter Christophe Poulain du Bignon. He was a sea captain and entrepreneur. During the American Revolution, he had harassed British shipping in the Indian Ocean, capturing a dozen ships and amassing a fortune. In 1794, he bought the island from Richard Leake. The Du Bignons would own the island for almost 100 years. Remember I said you wouldn't believe who bought the island next? In 1886, the island was sold to an exclusive hunting club. This club included J.P. Morgan, William Rockefeller, William K. Vanderbilt, and Joseph Pulitzer. It was called the Jekyll Island Club and was referred to as the richest, most exclusive, and most inaccessible club in the world. Holy cow, the money in that club. The club closed in 1942 due to World War II complications, and in 1947, the state of Georgia purchased the island. It wasn't until 1978 before the island was designated as a historic landmark. This is one of our favorite locations on Jekyll Island, the Georgia Sea Turtle Center. We were here last year and the rehab center was full of turtles. There were loggerhead turtles, leatherback turtles, green turtles, and my favorite, the hawksbill turtle.
So we're gonna take in the turtle sanctuary next while we're up here on Jekyll Island. So we'll take you inside and show you a few of them.
This is Patient Pelican. He's a green turtle. They found him on Cumberland Island on April 24th.
Look at the hatchlings in here, guys. They're all numbered, too. What kind of hatchlings are those? Those are diamondback terrapin hatchlings. We're back over here with Pelican. He's the only active one in here right now. Most of the patients have been released. Sad for us, but great news for the turtles.
Jekyll Island is truly a beautiful island. If you haven't been there, you should check it out. Whether you're interested in history of the island, or maybe the natural beauty of the beaches, or maybe you're looking for a nice bike ride, that's a great place to ride a bike. If you're a sea turtle enthusiast, either way, there's something on Jekyll Island for you to enjoy.
We just touched on some of the highlights of what you can expect to see on Jekyll Island in our shore visit. Have you ever been to Jekyll? Leave us a comment and let us know what your favorite part of the island is.
Well, that's going to wrap up this week's video, guys. I hope you enjoyed our tour of Jekyll Island. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe and click that bell icon so you'll be notified when we upload a new video.
And don't forget, if you like this video, make sure you give us a thumbs up. Stay safe out there, guys, and we'll see you next week.